Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to be making an enchilada casserole. So we're going to start with a deep skillet, and into that we're going to put some green chilies. These are chopped green chilies. I have a little can here that I think is 4 ounces, but I don't need all of that. And in fact, I'm going to use more of that in my topping. But right now, I just need 2 tablespoons, and you can drain it if you like. You can see there's some juice here that I did not drain off, but this is going to be a kind of a soupy consistency anyway. And if you like the extra heat, just go ahead and leave that undrained and put in 2 tablespoons of chopped green chilies. And then we come to salsa. And what I have here is some thick and chunky salsa. And it's medium in heat. You can get the hot kind if you like, and you don't have to get this brand. But what you need is 3/4 of a cup. So I've measured that out, and we'll just put that in. And you don't have to have the chunky kind. If you can't get that or don't want to use it, just any kind of salsa that you like. And then next, we have something that is scenting up the whole kitchen. All you can smell when you come into this room is cilantro. What I have is 1/4 cup, and we'll just put that in. And that's going to make it taste wonderful. And then I have black beans. These have been drained and rinsed. That's why they're sitting in my colander. And they're not even leaving any residue on the bottom because I drained them carefully and rinsed them. So let's put those in. And then we have Mexicorn, or as this is labeled, corn and peppers. So whatever brand you want to use, it's whole kernel corn, and it will have green bell pepper and red bell pepper in it. You'll see it on the picture on the front. And it has a little juice in it, but I'm just gonna leave that. It's not gonna hurt anything. And as I said, this is a juicy mixture when we get everything in. A little more in the bottom there. And one nice thing about putting this together is this part really doesn't require any extra spices, because everything we're putting in here, like with the salsa and here with the enchilada sauce, it's going to provide the spice, and then that cilantro is going to give that lovely flavor as well. So here we have a 10 ounce can of enchilada sauce, and we'll just put that in. And I think I have emptied out everything I had here. So this is the first part of the recipe. So I'm just going to stir this together and get it nice and blended. And then it will go to the stove. And I'm going to simmer this for about 20 minutes. I'm going to bring it to a boil over medium heat, and then reduce the heat and just let it cook down a little bit. If it looks like it's getting pretty dry, I'm going to add some water to it, because I would like for it to come out really just about like this. It looks good as it is, but if I cook it for 20 minutes, it may be more solid. And you can just take care of that to your own taste with putting more water in. So here it goes. We're going to turn it on medium-high heat, and then we'll reduce that to low in a few minutes. See you back then. Here's the part of the enchilada that we'll be putting in a dish and baking, and then we'll make a topping for it. But it's been cooking on the stove for 20 minutes, so I'm going to just take the spoon out and put it aside and turn this off and let it sit while I make the topping. Now this did not have any water added to it, and you can see the consistency. It's a little thicker than it was, but it's fine for our purposes. So let's get to making the topping. That's going to be a nice part of this casserole. It starts with some well-beaten eggs. So I have my eggs here. I have 2 well-beaten eggs. Then to that, I'm going to add 1 package of Jiffy corn muffin mix. So this is just your standard size, 8.5 ounces. That's going to go in here, along with some other things that we're going to mix up. Remember the chopped green chilies from the beginning? You'll need to use another tablespoon. Now this is a 1 tablespoon measure, so I'm just putting that in over to the side there. Here's something that you may or may not use very often. These are whole roasted peppers, and they are packed in olive oil. I just need 2 tablespoons worth. So I've chopped them up because they were whole, and there's a little bit of juice there with them. That's okay, you can allow that. Go ahead and put that in. And I'll give you some heat there, as well as some good flavor. And then I'm coming over here to the center and just mixing. So what I'm going to do is grab this, the skillet of prepared mixture, and I'm going to put it in a 13x9x2 baking dish that I've sprayed with cooking oil spray. So we just let that go to the bottom and spread it out so that it is even. So that looks pretty good. Looks like it's dispersed enough. And the thing about cooking it on the stove is that you get all of those good flavors combined. The cilantro was fresh from the garden, but it needed to get combined with the other flavors that came out of the cans, and they needed to combine with one another. So we have that done. And now the next step is to take our topping that we've just made of our cornmeal mix, and we're going to put that on top of this. Now it doesn't pour really well, so I'm just going to take a little at a time and spread it. So give me a moment here and I'll have it spread and then I'll come back. So I'm closing in on this corner over here, and you can see it's not that hard to spread, but you want a thin layer that is even all the way over the top. So this looks good, and what we're going to do is cook this before we deal with putting another topping on. That will just be browned off at the end, the cheese. So we're going to put our casserole so far into an oven that has been preheated to 400 degrees. And then we're going to bake it until this looks done, but it's not completely browned off. That's when we will put cheese on the top of it and continue to cook it, and it will brown off and look very nice. Casserole has been cooking for about 7 minutes, and you can see that the cornbread on the top is beginning to look done. That's because it's a very thin layer, so it's going to take less time than just your normal cornbread or even the corn muffins. So we're ready to put our next topping on, and that is Monterey Jack cheese. I've got the shredded variety, and I've measured out 1½ cups. So I'm going to just bring this a little closer to me so I can get this a little more even as I spread it, and just go all the way over the top with the Monterey Jack cheese. And this is going to be nice and brown and bubbly in just a few minutes. But it's had about 7 minutes of baking up to this point, and it'll probably take about 5 minutes or so to finish this off. But it should look really nice and appealing when we come back and get it later. So I'll see you back then. My enchilada casserole is done, and I did let the cheese brown for 5 minutes. Actually, the last half minute, I turned the oven to broil to make sure that it would get nice and brown. So it looks luscious. I want to show you what it looks like inside. So I have a serving plate here, and I'm just going to go to a corner, and what you want to see is some cornbread in there with this topping of cheese, and then underneath we have all of our lovely combination of, I'm going to turn this one upside down and then put another one on top of it. But I want you to see that combination of corn and beans and enchilada sauce. That's why it's called an enchilada casserole, is because of the enchilada sauce and also the additional combination of Tex-Mex type of flavors. So here we go. We'll put this right on top of that, and that makes a very nice luscious serving. So I'm going to come over here, and this is where I have my place setting, and I'm going to take some sour cream. This is fat-free sour cream, just a dollop, and put it on the top there. And I'm just going to snip some of the cilantro onto that sour cream. The contrasting color is great, and the flavor that it will add is wonderful too. So there's our dish for tonight, and with it, I have my nice glass of iced tea, And I think Rick and I will both enjoy having this for our dinner tonight. I hope you enjoy it.